Right. This man seems terribly attached to you. He's followed you everywhere in the past 2 years from one country to another.
Religious fanatic, huh?
Maybe he knows something about you.
All fanatics know things about me. They have a greater fear of me than love of their God.
Do you know that's the second time you've mentioned yourself and God in the same sentence? So, in fact, who are you?
I'm the Gaga Man. Boo.
My eyes, perversely shaken open, gazed for an instant upon a sight which no human creature could even imagine without panic, fear, and physical exhaustion. The things had filed ceremonially in one direction, the direction of the noisome wind, where the light of their torches showed their bended heads, or the bended heads of such as had heads. They were worshipping before a great, black, fetor-belching aperture which reached up almost out of sight, and which I could see was flanked at right angles by two giant staircases whose ends were far away in the shadow. One of these was indubitably the staircase I had fallen down. The dimensions of the whole were fully in proportion with those of the columns. An ordinary house would have been lost in it, and any average public building could easily have been moved in and out. It was so vast a surface that only by moving the eye could one trace its boundaries. So vast, so hideously black, and so aromatically stinking. Directly in front of this yawning polyphemus door, the things were throwing objects, evidently sacrifices or religious offerings to judge by their gestures. Kefren was their leader, sneering King Kefren, or the guide Abdul Reis, crowned with a golden shent and intoning endless formulae with the hollow voice of the dead. By his side knelt beautiful Queen Nitocris, whom I saw in profile for a moment, noting that the right half of her face was eaten away by rats or other ghouls. And I shut my eyes again when I saw what objects were being thrown as offerings to the fetid aperture or its possible local deity. It occurred to me that, judging from the elaborateness of this worship, the concealed deity must be one of considerable importance. Was it Osiris or Isis, Horus or Anubis, or some vast unknown god of the dead still more central and supreme? There is a legend that terrible altars and colossi were reared to an unknown one before ever the known gods were worshipped. And now, as I steeled myself to watch the rapt and sepulchral adorations of those nameless things, a thought of escape flashed upon me. The hall was dim, and the columns heavy with shadow. With every creature of that nightmare throng absorbed in shocking raptures, it might be barely possible for me to creep past through the faraway end of one of the staircases and ascend unseen, trusting to fate and skill to deliver me from the upper reaches.
La música de Harry Fry.
Ignition sequence start. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All engine running. Liftoff. We have a liftoff. 32 minutes past the hour. Liftoff on Apollo 11.
Tower clear. Stingray bought in the United States, I have some distressing news for you. A sinkhole has opened up inside the National Corvette Museum in the U.S. state of Kentucky. Eight cars have fallen into the hole, six of which belong to the museum in the city of Bowling Green. The other two were on loan from General Motors. Nobody, though, was at the museum when the ground caved in the early hours of the morning. The hole is believed to be about 12 meters wide. The hole is believed to be about 12 meters wide. But despite the damage that it's caused to the museum, it's open again for visitors, just shutting down one area, still letting people in.
Now now that this rig has gone under?
It has gone under the surface at about 10:21 this morning. Coast Guard got word that the vessel has gone under, and just recently we got word that the fire visibly has gone out.
What's the implication now of that having gone under? We've seen it burn, which means some petroleum was burning, natural gas or oil. At this point, is that oil in danger now of escaping into the sea?
That is correct. We've got the potential right now is you've got almost about 336,000 gallons. About 336,000 gallons of sweet light crude oil per day that was coming out of that well. So that oil will be, you know, released into the water now. So the priority is working with our partners in this, especially BP, and getting the environmental part of this underway. Coast Guard is still searching for those 11 missing crew members as well. But we have crews standing by out of Morgan City and all different staging areas to start doing everything we can to mitigate the pollution impact.
I know that you are working very hard to find those 11 missing. Workers. They are the 11 that are not accounted for. So 126, I believe, were rescued. 126, I believe, were rescued. 126, I believe, were rescued. 126, I believe, were rescued.
Among the 33 men trapped. Deep inside a Chilean copper mine. The men were chanting, "Long live Chile and long live the miners." At one point, they even sang the national anthem. Portions of the video of them were released by the government through the national television channel. They'd taken the pictures with a camera sent down to them through a small borehole drilled through to their emergency shelter. These two were even joking about getting out tomorrow, though that won't happen. They'll be trapped for weeks longer, perhaps even months, until the state-owned mining company drills an escape tunnel large enough to get them out.
Sometimes says 1,000 words, and what else can I say?